think the stock market reaction today, at least, looks like it is very, very harsh in nature.
Yeah, because I think the Nestle memories as well are pretty fresh in everyone's mind. So everyone's wondering whether this is going to escalate to a situation like a Nestle with regards to Maggi or not.
I mean, the only sort of organization or the only party you should really rely on is that it's something directly coming from the Food Administration Department. I mean, that voice really matters, and their stamp of approval or disapproval really matters. So the stock market reaction could be a different thing. But, you know, that's how markets are. In the short term, it's all about reaction. And in the short term, it's all about how they react in the short term. Okay, the management of Power Grid now joins us. Now, Power Grid Corporation may soon lose ownership of country's electricity transmission network as the Power Ministry has approached Cabinet with a proposal to amend the attracting private investment in the transmission space. Mr. I.S. Jha now joins us. He represents Power Grid, of course, the CMD there. Mr. Jha, can you confirm the report for us? I mean, can you really lose this status?
No, actually, what I understand that this is the wrong understanding. This is not, there is no proposal of leaving the ownership. Actually, Power Grid will continue to have win the bid, construct it, own it, operate it, etc. The proposal is only the planning part. Actually, what is happening today? We transmission system is planned by CEA and Power Grid system in planning. Then it go for the bidding in the PFC and the REC. Whoever wins, they construct, own, and build, operate it. Only that planning portion, which is the CTU function, what is that? That for that, now there will be a separate company which will plan, now bid out, like PFC, REC, bidding out, that company now will bid out. Power Grid is collecting the money for entire transition, all the licenses. That company will collect the money for private company, etc., whoever the transition license is. Power Grid will continue to own, operate, regulate, etc. This will give, it is the thinking that once the CPU function will go up, the Power Grid will be in advantage position. They can bid it freely, they can own it freely. Not only once CPU function goes off, then we can also go into distribution, we can go into any business. And that's why they are separating out the planning function, CPU function, not the ownership of the network. This is complete misunderstanding. I talked to the ET, they will put that clarification immediately. Something is misunderstanding. But actually,
if at all, Mr. Jha, do you think the government could move to make Power Grid only a transmission asset developer? And if that were to happen at all eventually, do you think that move would make sense?
Even today, we are the asset developer. Developer means, what do you mean by developer? Means own it, operate it, maintain it. Ownership will be on Power Grid. That is the basic purpose. Developer means that they will own the thing. It is not that will be given to anybody. Power Grid will continue to operate.
Okay,
but
fair point.
Mr. Jad, the idea behind opening up the transmission sector could be that the transmission sector right now needs a lot of investment, and Power Grid may not be in a capacity to really commit a lot of capital. I know you've increased your capex plan, but given that right now there is a complete mess in the transmission space, maybe there is case to open it up for the private sector.
No, it will not happen. That's the thing. This is misunderstanding. Tomorrow it will come. Clarification, we are trying to give it. Some communication misunderstanding there. I will talk to ET. It is Power Grid will continue to have. We have the strong CapEx program. We have the strong capitalization program. There is nothing we are going to go back. Okay. There is no planning as such in ministry. Some misunderstanding is there.
Thank you for clearing the air, and thank you for that clarification. So let me ask you some very basic questions. The way analysts look at Power Grid is that they always try to understand the total capex commitment, and that would be an indication of your profitability because you work on a cost plus model. So what is your capex commitment for FY17? And for an average viewer, can you also outline that how much your capex commitment is higher than FY16?
See, there are two things. One is this bidding out, Power Grid winning the transition, etc. This is continuing from 2011 onwards. That's why this is not the thing. How we get the project, we bid out, we tender out, we are winning the project, whatever tender out by PFCRDC, and that becomes the our asset. Our winning rate is 40 to 50%. That is not an issue. In addition to that, some exemption, like some project which is very urgent in nature, all the things, that also come to Power Grid. Power Grid has very strong capex program. As I told you that in 12th plan, we have the 110,000 capex program. Out of this 80,000, we have done it. And we have last year in financial 16, we have capitalized 30,000, more than 30,000 crores. This year also, and we are envisaging the same level of capitalization. That's why the business will continue the same pace, little bit more pace.
And very basic question again, sir. It may sound very simple for you, but this is just for the benefit of our viewers and for your shareholders. What is the return on equity currently you are enjoying? And going forward, will your return on equity remain intact, given that your outlay towards capex will go higher?
See, as you know that the projects which are doing it, the cost of basis, even today our major part is the cost of basis, their return on equity is 15.5% is the return on equity. If you do the project before time, which we generally do, then it's 0.5% additional. Then there's an incentive if you maintain the transmission availability with more than 98.8, then you will get the additional incentive. All together, this gives us the return on equity. When we bid for the new package in tariff bidding, this is the benchmark. This is the benchmark we keep it in the mind that this at least we get in the cost of this. If we are doing additional investment, then we must get at least that one. With that we are going ahead. And as far as Power Grid capex requirement is concerned, as I mentioned, the last year, earlier what was happened, our capex was always more than the capitalization. Capitalization gives back the money. Last year, the capitalization has gone up. Like capex, we have done 22,500 crores, and capitalization, we have done 30,000 crores. Means more project we have commissioned than capex we have done. That's a more internal resources is getting generated. This year also, we are targeting the more than 22,500 crores capex and capitalization in the same order of 30,000 crores. This is the basic concept, so that we will get the more internal resources.
Mr. Jha, such a pleasure that you could join in and really clarify what this means for Power Grid. So that's a important clarification really coming in from the management, saying that there is no change with regards to their structure. They continue to have a strong CapEx program for transmission business as well. And that's the word coming in from Power Grid, exclusively speaking with ET. Now, there is no proposal to hive off transmission ownership from the company, and that's a very important clarification from Power Grid, which, by the way, has recovered somewhat, just about nudging the green as we speak.